Good morning, students. In this video, we'll be seeing about the classification of company. So already we have seen what is a company and the features of company, advantages and disadvantages of a company form of organization. Now let us just recall what is company and then go directly into the chapter, that is classification of company on the basis of formation, on the basis of liability, on the basis of membership, on the basis of control, on the basis of place and others. And we'll also be seeing about the conclusion of this classification. So now let us go into the meaning of what is a company. The term company means a group or an association or person for carrying on business with a view to earn profit. So all type of business organizations are formed with a view of earning profit, and company is also a form of organization or association or a group of persons carrying on a business for earning profit motive. Company is an artificial person. Already we have seen in the features of company, created by law, and it is created according to the Companies Act. Previously it was created by Companies Act of 1956, and later it was clarifications, and now we are following the Companies Act of 2013 and destroyed by law. It is an association of person to start a business under legal guidance. The precise definition of country varies from company varies from country to country. So this we have already seen in the previous video. So these are some of the important features that you have to keep in mind. See here, incorporated association. It has got a common seal, and the shares are easily transferable. It is an artificial person and it has got separate legal entity. Now, what do you mean by incorporated association? It is registered under the Companies Act of 2013. It has got a common seal. The common seal is nothing but it is considered as the signature of the company. Where and all the common seal is affixed, it will be treated as the signature of the company. And the emblem of the company will be engraved in the common seal. Transferable shares. The shares which the shareholders hold can be easily transferred from one person to another person. An artificial person. It has got a separate legal entity and it is considered as the artificial person. It can be sued and it can sue others in case of any contingencies. So these are the important features of company form of organization. And now we are going to see the classification of company form of organization. So companies are broadly classified on the basis of incorporation, membership, member liability, control and nationality. So let us see the subdivision. Based on incorporation, they are divided into chartered company, statutory company and association not for profit. So these are the subdivisions based on incorporation. Now based on membership, they are divided into public company and private company. So next is member liability, that is based on liability of a person. The companies are divided by limited by shares and limited by guarantee and unlimited liability, and companies having unlimited liability. Based on control, companies are again divided into three categories. They are government companies, holding companies and subsidiary companies. Nationality, that is based on nationality, companies are domestic company, foreign company and multinational company. So these are the different classification of companies that we are going to see in detail in the future, that is further coming clippings. Classification of company on the basis of formation of a company. The companies are divided into statutory company, chartered company and registered company. So these are the three types of companies based on formation or incorporation of a company. Now statutory company. Now let us see the first type of company, which is based on formation or incorporation of a company. A company which is incorporated by means of special act of the parliament or any state legislature. These are governed by the acts of creating them. In such type of companies, The memorandum of association and the article of association is not required, and the annual reports are presented in parliament. So let us see, this is an example that I have given you, Reserve Bank of India and LIC, that is Life Insurance Corporation of India. They are statutory companies which are created by special act by any one of the governments, that is either the central government or state government. They will be state legislature, they will be forming these type of companies, and these are governed by the acts that are created by them. And such type of companies do not require memorandum of association and articles of association. These are the important documents which are involved in forming a information of a company. But when it is a statutory company, they are governed by the act they are created by. So these are the two examples you can keep it in mind. That is the Reserve Bank of India and the Life Insurance Corporation of India. So next we are going to see what is the registered company and what is the chartered company. Now first let us see what is a registered company. Companies registered under the Companies Act of 2013 or earlier act or registered companies. Earlier act is nothing but the Companies Act of 1956. Companies registered under the Companies Act of 1956 and Companies Act of 2013, they come under the category of registered company. Such companies cannot come into existence until it is registered and a certificate of incorporation has been granted by the registrar of the company. So these types of companies should get a certificate of incorporation, that is certificate of formation of company. It has to be registered by the registrar of the company. So next is chartered company. Company is created by a special charter. Now what do you mean by a charter? Charter is nothing but a written statement of the rights, beliefs and purpose or of an organization. So these are usually given by the head of the state. That is, it will be charter. இதுக்கு தமிழ் டேர்ம் என்னன்னா சாசனம் அப்படின்னு சொல்கிறது. கம்பெனிஸ் கிரியேட்டட் பை ஸ்பெஷல் சார்ட்டர் பை மொனார்க், தட் இஸ் த ஹெட் ஆஃப் த ஸ்டேட், கிங் ஆர் குவீன். த பவர்ஸ் ஆஃப் சார்ட்டர் கம்பெனிஸ் இஸ் டிஃபைன்ட் பை த சார்ட்டர், அ டாக்குமெண்ட் டு இன்கார்பரேட் இன்ஸ்டிடியூஷன் அண்டர் விச் இட் இஸ் incorporated. Example, East India Company, Bank of England. It does not exist in India. Actually, these are all foreign companies. So they were all created by special charters which were given by the king or the queen of a country. So this you have to keep in mind. Next is classification of a company on the basis of liability of members. Now what do you mean by liability? Already we have been seeing this in the previous videos right from the beginning of the commerce subject. Liability is the amount that is due to be paid to the outsiders, to the third parties, to the creditors. So it is limited by share, limited by guarantee and unlimited liability. So on the basis of liability of members, the company is divided into three types. Limited is by share, limited by guarantee and limited unlimited liability. Now let us see in detail what is limited by share. These type of company have a share capital and liability of each member or the company is limited by the memorandum to the extent of the face value of the share subscribed to by him. Such company is called limited by share. A company limited by share may be a public company or a private company. So limited by share. Now let us see what these companies are. That is, they have to pay only the amount that is the share value of each of the company is limited by shares. Maybe either the public company or private company. If a member has paid the full amount of the shares, then his liability shall be nil. Thus, two main features of the limited by shares are as follows. The liability of its members is limited to the amount remaining unpaid on the shares held by them. such liability can be enforced either during the lifetime of the company or during the winding of the company. Say for example, let us take A has got share values of rupees 10 and he is holding 10,000 shares in a company and he has paid up to rupees 7, then his liability to pay to the creditors is only rupees 3 and he need not pay the paid up value of the shares, that is rupees 7. So his liability will be to the amount of rupees 3 per share. So 30,000, because he is holding 10,000 shares, so his liability will be to the extent of rupees 30,000 only and he need not pay rupees 1 lakh. So liability by guarantee, next type of company is liability by guarantee. These types of companies may or may not have a share capital. Each member promises to pay a fixed sum of money specified in the memorandum in the event of liquidation of the company for payment of the debt and liabilities of the company. These amount promised by him is called as the guarantee. So they may not even have share capital, they might have not invested in the share capital, but each member might have guaranteed to pay a certain amount at the time of liquidation of the company and they will be limited to that amount only. Then next is unlimited liability. This already we have seen in very clear detail. Section 2 and subsection 92 of the Companies Act 2013 gives option to promoters to form a company with unlimited liability. A company not having any limit on the liability of its members is called an unlimited company. And an unlimited company may be public or private company, and the personal property of the members of such companies may be required to pay the company's losses from at the time of liquidation or at the time of winding up of the company. So their personal property is also taken into account to pay the creditors. And because such companies are separate legal entity, its creditors cannot file a suit against the members directly. The creditors will have to apply to the court for the winding up of the company, and then the liquidator will direct the members to contribute to the assets of the company to pay off its liabilities. So this you have to keep in mind. Next is classification of company on the basis of membership pattern. So they are divided into public limited company and private limited company. One person company and small company, its feature is one person company and small company, and listed company and unlisted company. Now let us see what is a private company and what is a public company. So now let us see what is private limited company. Minimum paid up capital. The private company will be having a minimum paid up capital of rupees 1 lakh and the minimum number of members are 2 and the maximum number of members are 200. Previously it was only, according to the Companies Act of 1956, it was only 50. But now they have increased the maximum number of members to 200. And right to transfer of shares is restricted in case of private limited company and cannot invite public to subscribe to its shares. And the private limited company has to mention the word private limited company while writing the company's name. And Reliance Industries Limited Growth is Life. This is their version motto. And Reliance is an example for private limited company, and Tata Consultancy Services is an example for private limited company. So you have to keep these important 5 points in your mind regarding private limited company. Their minimum capital is 1 lakh, minimum number of members are 2, maximum number of members are 200. It restricts the rights, transfer of shares is restricted and cannot invite public subscription to the shares. So these 5 points must be kept in mind. The private company can be further categorized as one person company and small company. Now let me explain what is one person company. One person company is incorporated as private limited company. minimum capital, paid up capital is rupees 1 lakh and no right to transferability of shares, the word one person company should be mentioned in the bracket below the name of such company. So if it is a private company and if it is a one person company, below the name it has to be clearly mentioned that it is a one person company. And as such it is following the same share capital amount is one, minimum paid up capital is 1 lakh, and again the right to transferability of shares is restricted, and the word one person company should be mentioned in the bracket. And what is small company? It is a private, it is also a private company. The paid up capital of not more than rupees 50 lakh or turnover not more than rupees 2 crore. That is the limitation. And one person company is a type of small company. So one person company also comes under the category of small company. So these are the features of private company categorization. Now let us move on to public limited company, that is section 2, subsection 7.1. Minimum paid up capital is rupees 5 lakh. Then minimum number of members are restricted to 7. There is no limit for maximum number of members as in the case of 200. In case of private limited company, here there is no limitation for maximum members. There can be any number of members in case of public limited company. And shares are freely transferable. That is another advantage here. They have to invite public to subscribe to its shares. This is another advantage of public limited company. Now let me again recall, the maximum paid up capital is rupees 5 lakh. The minimum number of members are 7. The maximum number of members, there is no limitation for its maximum membership. And shares are freely transferable and they have to invite public subscription for their capital in the form of shares. And ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Commission, that is an example of public limited company. And Coal India Limited, that is also an example for public limited company. So the public limited company can be further categorized as listed company and unlisted company. Now, what do you mean by listed company? Let us see. A listed company means a company which is listed on different stock exchanges in India or outside India, and their shares are traded on stock exchanges. Now, what do you mean by listed in stock exchanges? Their names, the company names will be given in the list of the, will be marked in the list of the stock exchanges, and only those companies which are listed in the name of the stock exchanges will be allowed to trade or will be allowed to buy and shares in the stock exchange. For listing company, made an agreement with stock exchange and follow the guidelines given in listing agreement of every stock exchange. Now let me give you some clarification here. Listing அப்படினா என்ன அர்த்தம்னா, இந்த கம்பெனியோட நேம் வந்து ஸ்டாக் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்சோடைய பட்டியலில் இடம் பெற்றிருக்கும். அவங்களோட நேம் வந்து இந்த லிஸ்ட்டில் இருக்கும். அப்படி இருந்தால் மட்டும்தான் அவங்க அங்கே ட்ரேடிங் ஆக்டிவிட்டீஸை கேரி அவுட் பண்ண முடியும். ட்ரேடிங் அப்படின்னா என்ன? பையிங் அண்ட் செல்லிங் ஆஃப் ஷேர்ஸ். அப்போ அங்கே அந்த நேம் இருந்தால் மட்டும்தான், அந்த ஸ்டாக் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்சில் அந்த கம்பெனியோட நேம் இருந்தால் மட்டும்தான் ஒரு கம்பெனி வந்து, ஒரு பப்ளிக் லிமிடெட் கம்பெனி வந்து தங்களோட ஷேர்ஸை வாங்கவோ விற்கவோ முடியும். இன்னொரு கம்பெனியோட ஷேர்ஸையும் வாங்கலாம். அப்படி இருந்தால் மட்டும்தான், லிஸ்ட் பண்ணியிருந்தால் மட்டும்தான் முடியும். அன்லிஸ்டட் கம்பெனி, அன்லிஸ்டட் கம்பெனி மீன்ஸ் அ கம்பெனி ஹூஸ் ஷேர்ஸ் ஆர் நாட் அவைலபிள் டு ஜென்ரல் பப்ளிக் ஃபார் ட்ரேடிங் அண்ட் நாட் லிஸ்டட் டு ஸ்டாக் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்ச். An unlisted company can be private or public limited company. இவங்களுடைய நேம் லிஸ்ட் வந்து ஸ்டாக் எக்ஸ்சேஞ்சில் இருக்காது. இவங்களோட ஷேர்ஸ் வந்து அங்கே வந்து விற்கவோ வாங்கவோ படாது. ஆனால் ஒரு அன்லிஸ்டட் கம்பெனி வந்து ப்ரைவேட் கம்பெனியாகவும் இருக்கலாம், பப்ளிக் கம்பெனியாகவும் இருக்கலாம். நெக்ஸ்ட்டு லெட் இஸ் மூவ் ஆன் டு த நெக்ஸ்ட் கிளிப்பிங். கிளாசிஃபிகேஷன் ஆஃப் கம்பெனி ஆன் த பேசிஸ் ஆஃப் லயபிலிட்டி ஆஃப் மெம்பர்ஸ். They are again divided into three. One is holding company, the other one is the subsidiary company and government company. Now, what is meant by holding company and what is meant by subsidiary company? Holding company வந்து இன்னொரு கம்பெனியோட ஷேர்ஸ் மேக்ஸிமம் நம்பர் ஆஃப் ஷேர்ஸ் அட்லீஸ்ட் 51% ஆஃப் தி ஷேர்ஸை வந்து தன் வசம் வைத்திருந்தால் அது ஹோல்டிங் கம்பெனி. ஒரு ஸ்மால் கம்பெனி அப்படின்னா அது வந்து சப்சிடரி கம்பெனி. சப்சிடரி அப்படின்னாலே ஒரு அதுக்கு கீழே இருக்கக்கூடிய கம்பெனி அப்படின்னு அர்த்தம். ஸோ இந்த ரெண்டு கேட்டகரிஸையும் நம்ம பார்த்துடலாம். வாட் இஸ் அ ஹோல்டிங் கம்பெனி, வாட் இஸ் சப்சிடரி கம்பெனி அண்ட் வாட் இஸ் கவர்மெண்ட் கம்பெனி. ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் லைபிலிட்டி ஆஃப் மெம்பர்ஸ். கவர்மெண்ட் கம்பெனி செக்ஷன் 2 சப்செக்ஷன் 45 ஆஃப் த கம்பெனிஸ் ஆக்ட் டிஃபைன்ஸ் அ கவர்மெண்ட் கம்பெனி இஸ் அ கம்பெனி இன் விச் அட்லீஸ்ட் 51% ஆஃப் த பெய்ட் அப் ஷேர் கேபிட்டல் இஸ் ஹெல்ட் பை த கவர்மெண்ட். அ கவர்மெண்ட் கம்பெனி மே பி ப்ரைவேட் ஆர் பப்ளிக் கம்பெனி. எம்ப்ளாயி ஆஃப் கவர்மெண்ட் கம்பெனி ஆர் நாட் எம்ப்ளாயீஸ் ஆஃப் த சென்ட்ரல் ஆர் ஸ்டேட் கவர்மெண்ட். ஸோ இதை மைண்டில் கீப் அப் பண்ணிக்கணும். இவங்க வந்து கவர்மெண்ட் எம்ப்ளாயீஸ் கிடையாது, கவர்மெண்ட் கம்பெனி வேறு, சென்ட்ரல் கவர்மெண்ட்டோ அல்லது ஸ்டேட் கவர்மெண்ட்டுங்கிறது வேறு. ஸோ தே வில் பி ஹெல்ட் த ஷேர் கேபிட்டல் வில் பி ஷேர்ஸ் பெய்டப் ஷேர் வந்து யார் கையில் இருக்குன்னா, யார் வசம் இருக்குன்னா கவர்மெண்ட் வசம் இருக்கும். நம்பர் 51% ஆஃப் த ஷேர்ஸ் ஹோல்டிங் கம்பெனி அக்கார்டிங் டு செக்ஷன் 2 சப்செக்ஷன் 46. இந்த செக்ஷன்ஸ்லாம் ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்கணும், ஏன்னா இட்ஸ் ஆல் ஒன் மார்க் குவெஸ்சன். ஆஃப் த கம்பெனிஸ் ஆக்ட் 2013 கம்பெனி விச் கண்ட்ரோல் அனதர் கம்பெனி இஸ் நோன் அஸ் ஹோல்டிங் கம்பெனி. இன்னொரு கண்ட்ரியை இன்னொரு கம்பெனியை வந்து கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ணிச்சுன்னா தென் தட் கம்பெனி இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் அ ஹோல்டிங் கம்பெனி. அண்ட் எந்த கம்பெனி கண்ட்ரோல்டாக இருக்கோ அதுக்கு கீழே வந்து செயல்படுதோ அந்த கம்பெனிக்கு பேர் சப்சிடரி கம்பெனி. அக்கார்டிங் டு செக்ஷன் 2 சப்செக்ஷன் 87 ஆஃப் த கம்பெனிஸ் ஆக்ட் ஏ சப்சிடரி கம்பெனி இன் ரிலேஷன் டு அனதர் கம்பெனி தட் இஸ் டு எனி த ஹோல்டிங் கம்பெனி மீன்ஸ் அ கம்பெனி இன் விச் த ஹோல்டிங் கம்பெனி. ஸோ ஒரு ஹோல்டிங் கம்பெனிக்கு கீழே செயல்பட்டுச்சுன்னா அந்த கம்பெனிக்கு பேர் வந்து சப்சிடரி கம்பெனி அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவோம். ஸோ கவர்மெண்ட் ஹோல்டிங் அண்ட் சப்சிடரி வி ஹவ் சீன். நவ் லெட் அஸ் சீ கிளாசிஃபிகேஷன் ஆஃப் கம்பெனி ஆன் த பேசிஸ் ஆஃப் ரெஜிஸ்ட்ரேஷன். ஆன் த பேசிஸ் ஆஃப் ரெஜிஸ்ட்ரேஷன் தே ஆர் கிளாசிஃபைட் ஆஸ் ஃபாரின் கம்பெனி ஆர் இந்தியன் கம்பெனி, தட் இஸ் டொமஸ்டிக் கம்பெனி ஆர் ஃபாரின் கம்பெனி. பேஸ்ட் ஆன் நேஷ்னாலிட்டி, தே கேன் ஆல்சோ பி செட் அஸ் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் கம்பெனிஸ் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் நேஷ்னாலிட்டிஸ் ஆர் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் ரெஜிஸ்ட்ரேஷன், ஃபாரின் கம்பெனி ஆர் டொமஸ்டிக் கம்பெனி. ஸோ த பெஸ்ட் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஃபார் அ ஃபாரின் கம்பெனி இஸ் KFC. ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் அ ஃபாரின் கம்பெனி. ஆஸ் பர் செக்ஷன் 2 subsection 42 of the Companies Act, a foreign company means any company or body corporate incorporate outside India which has a place of business in India, whether by itself or through an agent, or carries on business physically or through electronic mode and conduct any business activity in India in any other manner. For example, Samsung, Apple, etc. are examples of foreign company. And another example is KFC, which I have given it to you in the clipping here. Now, let us see what is a Indian company or domestic company. Indian company is a company which is registered in India, and an Indian company is one which gets itself registered by following the procedures enumerated in the Companies Act of 2000 or the previous Act of 1956. So these are the subdivisions that we have seen so far, and thank you, children.